I'm Faith Fitzpatrick. I work at the U.S. Geological Survey with a team of scientists studying the effects of urbanization on stream ecosystems. In this video, we'll look at how urban development alters the habitat or the physical features where creatures live in or near the streams. Habitat is made up of four basic things: water, shelter, food, and space. Flowing water is important to provide a diversity of habitats and food for all sorts of creatures. Healthy streams typically have a range of flows that change through the seasons. Healthy stream habitats have a diversity of water velocity and depth combinations and geomorphic features, such as shallow rapids and deep pools, and many bends and curves. Boulders and logs in the stream and grass and shrubs along its banks offer protection during floods and provide food and cover from predators. It's not just the stream that provides habitat for fish, but how the stream is connected to the land and low-lying areas along its banks. Low areas right next to the stream help alleviate flooding and also provide shelter, refuge, and food for amphibians, insects, reptiles, and birds. In urban watersheds, runoff from roads, parking lots, and rooftops, and the addition of storm sewers cause more frequent and erosive flows because less rainfall is soaked into the ground. Storm flow acts like a fire hose that scours stream beds and banks and destroys and unravels the physical features that aquatic creatures call home. Sand, silt, and clay from bare soils at construction sites smother gravel riffles, clog channels, and fill in pools. Fine sediment can accumulate contaminants and nutrients and is a real problem in streams with gentle slopes. As streams are lined with cement, go underground, or are altered by dams and road crossings, the connections among habitats are lost, limiting the movement of fish and other organisms. Vegetation along an urban stream is frequently overrun by aggressive invasive plants. Most invasive plants start out in people's gardens, but they easily spread to banks, floodplains, and wetlands, where they crowd out native plants. As people connect with their streams, watershed volunteer groups connect with regional planning commissions, sewerage districts, and city planners and engineers to improve the livability of urban stream corridors for both wildlife and humans.
So you have more power than you think, because a lot of us don't make time to let our voices be heard.
The Milwaukee Metropolitan Sewerage District has been able to speed up its goal of removing or redesigning cement-lined channels that block fish passage. These rehabilitation projects are reconnecting habitats and also improving aesthetics and safety for people while maintaining flood control. Because of the importance of preserving salmon and other species on the endangered species list, habitat improvement and protection in the Portland, Oregon area is first and foremost in rehabilitation projects. Large logs are used in many of the rehabilitation projects to provide shelter and resting places for fish and other creatures. The protection of Chesapeake Bay has brought together a diverse group of water resources planners and managers, as well as engineers, ecologists, and landscape architects. They've been using sand seepage systems, base flow channels, and plants to filter stormwater. These techniques reduce runoff, peak storm flows, bank erosion, and gullying, while improving infiltration, water quality, and habitat. An important part of rehabilitation projects is measuring success. Monitoring flow, water quality, habitat, and biological characteristics before, during, and after rehabilitation activities are especially critical for projects where there is a high risk to infrastructure or endangered species. For urban streams, hope for habitat is all about connections. Reconnecting the continuum of habitats that streams provide from their headwaters to mouths, reconnecting streams to floodplains and wetlands, and most importantly, reconnecting people with each other and their streams.
Thanks for your interest in our study of the urbanization effects of stream ecosystems conducted as part of the National Water Quality Assessment Program of the U.S. Geological Survey. Please visit our website for more information about the study and also access to our data and our reports.